Welcome everybody to a bonus episode of Metroid Prime. Alright, so basically there's a lot of extra things in the game that I wanted to show off. So here's the LP file, here's the backup file, and I guess this would be the practice file. And basically everything you do in the game, you get achievements, and you can use the achievements to get stuff under the extras section. So there's concept gallery that we got here. Each concept gallery will cost 2 orange tokens. As long as you've beaten the game, you should have enough tokens to get every gallery. And I guess I'll be showing this. But you get the orange tokens or credits or whatever you want to call them. You get them from beating bosses. So as long as you beat the game, you should have enough credits to get everything here. So I'm just gonna spend a minute flipping through all these pictures. You can zoom in and out and stuff, but it's sort of like you can't get rid of this little banner or anything. You can pan around if you want, but these are some really interesting sketches on like what the game might have been like, all that sort of stuff. 34. Let's do this quickly. You could probably look up most of this stuff, like on Metroid. The Metroid database has a bestiary, and they've got at least half of every enemy that's ever appeared in the Metroid series. They also have, you know, characters, but there's not a whole lot of characters in Metroid. There's just like Samus, Dark Samus, and those people from Metroid Other M that nobody really cares about, I guess. And then there's, well, I guess Adam was technically in Metroid Fusion first, and also in the Metroid manga, which came out, I believe the Metroid manga came out after Metroid 1, but before Metroid 2, so it's pretty old. So that's where Adam actually came from, because it came out way before the Metroid Fusion game. And then there's Extras Gallery. This is actually a gallery for Metroid Fusion. I've already LP'd Metroid Fusion, but I don't know if there's any, I don't know if there's an actual gallery in Metroid Fusion, but this game came out at about the same time, so they just sort of added it. The original GameCube version is what I mean. And, once again, as long as you beat the game, you should have access to all that. Another thing is the bonus gallery. There's only one bonus for Metroid Prime, and that would be the fusion suit, which is currently on. Basically, it changes whatever suit you have into the fusion suit, but it's a first-person game, so it really doesn't make that much of a difference. The cutscenes are obviously different, but that's pretty much it. That costs 1 silver credit and 2 orange credits. So that's how much it costs, if you were wondering. Here is the soundtrack gallery. Every single soundtrack costs 1. It costs 1 silver credit. The thing about silver credits is, to get every silver credit and unlock every soundtrack as well as the fusion suit, you have to get 100% scans. And I'm actually gonna show you guys what New Game Plus is actually like. I'll show you on this file actually. But basically there's a few differences, and I'm gonna show you what the fusion suit looks like at the same time. So I'm just gonna skip the loading. I'm just gonna put it on normal. This is the actual normal. This is easy, normal, hard. So I don't know. So I'm just gonna skip the loading and show you what it looks like. Alright, so that's basically what the fusion suit looks like. As for the what I've been calling New Game Plus, I don't know exactly what everyone else calls it, but it's pretty much what it is. Basically, your scans carry over. So as you can see on this file, I've gotten 100% scans, and even if I start a new game, everything is here. So that's really nice. But the best thing about it is it makes going through the game so much faster, and I'll show you why. Watch this. Notice? Everything is already scanned. Therefore, you don't have to go through the scanning animation. So, if we go... Wow, I missed. Really? But if we go in here where there's stuff to scan and whatnot, we'll find that everything has already been scanned, and it saves a ton of time. Seriously, like, just instantly works. And it doesn't make a huge difference in some places, but in some instances, it makes going through the game so much faster. And it's surprising how there's really not a lot of official speedruns of this game. I think I might go for a speedrun at some point, but that's another story for another day. But anyways, I'm not LPing this game again right now. But that's pretty much what I wanted to show you guys. Is that everything's all... I mean, everything's all taken care of. We got 100% items, got almost 100% scans, showed you guys all the bonuses here, and that's basically it. There's only one little thing I want to show you. In that one little thing I wanted to show you, I finally got over 200 hours on Metroid Prime Trilogy. That doesn't include the probably at least 80 hours spent on the original GameCube version of Metroid Prime 1. That's pretty insane, and that number is gonna get a lot higher because I will be LPing Metroid Prime 2 and 3, and Prime 2 will definitely require a practice file and all that stuff. So, yeah, once again, thanks for watching the LP if you did, and if you're just watching this, thanks for watching, and, I'll see you guys in the update video, which will be coming out probably the same day, where it's just a nice little update video, probably like 5 minutes long, not too sure, but, I'll see you guys then.